for coming today. Please stand. And the first thing we will do is we'll go ahead and light the candles. And Miss Marie, can I ask you to light the candles, please, symbolizing mind, body, and spirit?
Sure.
Thank you. Please join me in an attitude of prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the blessings of this amazing and beautiful day. Thank you so much for the blessings of each person who's here, who's chosen to come and to spend time absorbing the love and light from you and celebrating all that is and all that can be and shall be from thee. We ask this in your precious name. Amen.
Want to stand up? I think they can hear you better.
Yeah.
Ready when you are.
Came to me during my meditation about this event that may be occurring. It's not my job, it's personal. Was that life is a gift to us. The way we perceive it is how we create most of the happiness in our lives. The events that were presented to us, it's up to us to decide how we're going to feel about those things and act about those things. And when this event was presented to me, I got this feeling of dread, a feeling of inevitability about things. And that's all I felt in the beginning. That might be surprising about somebody like me that's had a lot of spiritual training. But I'm still a human being and I still walk on the earth and I still react to things. And I went to bed feeling like that. And I woke up this morning and went at it again, thinking about it, trying to sort out of it and get the right of it. And as soon as I stopped being driven by that sense of inevitability, I began to get a little bit of peace about the situation, a little bit of calm in my life about it. And I'm not saying that it's going to be completely acceptable to me or that it's going to be this joyous, happy thing that I sing and dance through. But when I got out of that sense of inevitability about it, I re-employed my spiritual mind and my spiritual thoughts. And that allows me to think of options. It allows me to think past the event. that allows me to see my life going on rather than being locked into that event, waiting for the event to happen, or waiting to resolve the event. I know there's a number of people in the congregation going through things like this, so it's odd how this energy seems to be cycling among people in the same mind. So I ask you to just think about this. When something is about to happen, or you feel that it's going to happen, and it doesn't seem to be avoidable, don't let that sense of inevitability be all that you feel, all that drives your thoughts at the moment. Initially, that may be it, but as people that know about meditation, as people that know about the higher connection to the mind of God, we have an extra tool to deal with this with. Once we're done being human, we have the ability to connect back to that spirit mind that we've developed and nurtured over the years. And it's kind of like an insurance policy. That's why I meditate, not because I have it to be happy every day. But I meditate to have an insurance policy there for when times like this come. It softens the blow. It allows me to connect back to myself once I get back up. I remember my father told me one time, he was just a real tough guy, a real hard guy. Never understood kids or love about kids. But he was real tough about life. And he told me, he said, you know, there's nothing wrong with getting knocked down. He said, the mistake is not getting back up again. He said, that's what you have to do, is get back up and go back at it again. Because he said, nobody's going to pick you back up. You have to do it yourself most of the time. Pick yourself back up and look at it again. And that's how I got by that sense of inevitability, was to get back up, think past the event, think about the joy of my life, think about the gift of life, and move past that one event. So I thank you for listening.
Comes with Marty sometimes. So we're going to do hymn number 6, which is Near My God to Be.
Still,
welcome if you're a first-time visitor. If you need to use facilities, they're down around the corner to the left, to the left. And please make sure that you silence your cell phone, because it's very often that God will call during a service. That's just what happens. Our service is actually, oh, and one other thing, in the other room, we do have a paper on the right-hand side room. We have all kinds of different information that's available, along with a paper that's there to put your name and address on if you want to receive information about the church. And there's also a healing list there available, too. So, our church is comprised of three different portions. We have our healing portion, then we have our inspirational lecture, and then we are followed by the demonstration of spiritual gifts. And so we're going to first move forward into our healing portion. And so we've got two chairs in the back, and we're going to have healers. And I haven't pre-asked everyone, anyone. Phil, would you like to be a healer today?
Yes.
Rosa, would you like to?
Sure.
Love it. Okay, wonderful. So go ahead to the back. I will go ahead and lead you in a guided meditation during that time. If you hear this, then that means that a healing chair has become available. We're going to go ahead and start by reading on the very back of your hymnals the prayer for spiritual healing. So please join me. I ask the great unseen healing force to remove all obstructions from my mind and body, and to restore me to perfect health. I ask this in all sincerity and honesty, and I will do my part. I ask this great unseen healing force to help both present and absent ones who are in need of help, and to restore them to perfect health. I put my trust in the love and power of God. So please, go ahead and get yourself comfortable. Relax in your seat. Take a deep breath and be comfortable. Uncross your legs and put your hands with your palms upward in your lap. Close your eyes and follow along. Inhale and exhale. As you inhale, you're inhaling God's love and light. As you exhale, you're releasing any tension in your body, out the bottoms of your feet. Inhale and exhale. Quiet your body. Quiet your mind. Allow the chatter to slowly stop and be. Be in this space. Be in this place and follow the guidance from above. Start by relaxing all the different parts of your body. Starting at the feet and your legs. Allow all stress and tension to flow through the bottom of your feet. You're feeding our Mother Earth. Feel the relaxation go through your thighs and your hips, and again down and out the bottoms of your feet. Feel the relaxation continue through your torso and your back, slowly releasing. Feel the relaxation across your shoulders, down your arms, and out through your fingers. Continue to feel the relaxation through your neck, and up to your head, and all around your head, your face muscles, your brain activity slows down and just is. Bring your awareness higher to the top of your head, at your crown chakra, and feel it open. Open as if a lotus flower is unfolding on top of your head. As it opens, you feel golden love showering down and into and through you. It's the essence of God. It's the grace of pure Lord love flowing into you and sparkling, shimmering, and filling your physical body. You feel it as it comes into and out of and all around your face, down your shoulders, through your spine, through your torso, down your legs, and out through the bottoms of your feet. Allow this free-flowing love to continue through your full body and out back into feeding our Mother Earth.
You see,
You feel and you know. You're glowing in the pure love of golden essence of all that's connected into and through each of you. You feel every molecule in your body is pulsing and vibrating. It's spectacular. It's brilliant. Stay in that space with the heart connection. There's a message for you. Open your heart and listen.
Abundance is never ending and is there for you.
turn to go now. And you feel full, exuberant. And you continue down the path, forward. You continue feeling that golden love. You know the heart connection is there. It has all been refilled and re-nourished for you. You continue forward until you see the stairs. And you start down the stairs. You continue to feel the golden shimmering all around you. And you go to the violet stair, down to the blue, to the green, down to the yellow, and the orange, and the red. You continue down. Now it's time to enter the physical once again. You find your spirit settling back into your body. You feel the chair beneath you. You begin to feel your body parts. You continue to feel the tingling of the love, the golden love and light that fills your heart, mind, spirit, and soul. You are whole. You are one. You are blessed, and you are a blessing. Take a deep breath in. Inhale and exhale. And inhale and exhale. Get yourself fully settled and open your eyes when you're ready. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Ooh, holy moly, that was a hot one.
I thought when I felt it like that was wonderful. That was wonderful.
All of the above.
Oh, I love it.
Please stand. Let's go ahead and grab ourselves for the song. Miss Marty, please direct us.
Oh, People's Church. Let's romp and stomp. You know, dance is sacred too, so if you ever feel like moving and swaying to these, that's part of prayer. Let's do Peace by the River in number 18. Y'all are the heartbeat of the church and the chorus of unity, people's church.
Reverend Machado has spent 9 years traveling the globe
at the side of John of God. So please help me in welcoming. She's just following the energy.
Hi.
Hi.
It's nice to be back. Nice to see some pleasant new faces and some old faces. Old youthful faces. I think Pastor, see? I'll just hold the button. Okay, now you're good. It's my heartbeat. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
All right. Great. I think Pastor Steve said it the best, you know. When we sit and think about life, we often get in a state of contemplation as to what's going to happen next. And then we find ourselves in dismay. So today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about how we think and what we consider to be our truth. That thinking. Now, most of you recognize that you have an innate ability to create your reality, right? You all know that. But most of us spend time thinking that somebody else did it to us. That we had someone outside the forces of our own being that was a catalyst to create the change for us that we needed. But what I would tell you is that as we start to live our lives, we start to create an environment that allows us to see and perceive differently. And in an effort for that to cause change in our lives, we start to bring the mirror forward. You are all mirrors. You are the mirrors of yourself when you see yourself in the morning, gazing while you're brushing your teeth, and going, who is that? But most of the day, you do not see yourselves. You only see yourself through someone else's eyes. You see yourself through the person that comes before you, whether it be in the grocery store when you're standing in the 15-item line and they have 22 items. And you see your reaction to that individual. Are you patient and kind? Or you're short and frustrated. It will tell you a lot about where you are in simple situations like this. But there are more than those events that happen in the grocery store, but the events that happen throughout the day. And it does not matter the shape nor the size of the individual that will come before you. It could be as simple as a little child to give you a new perspective on life and its freedom. Something that you at one time knew very well and somehow managed to forget. As wisdom and age started to come in. I would tell you that the wisdom is the most important and the age is only a perception. That you can be as young as you think you are. And you can live for as long as you wish to. Now most people would say, wow, how's that possible? I have a drop dead date with God. But you have to remember that you are also co-creator with that God. And that God essence is listening to your desires, your passions, your loves, and asking what it is that you wish for yourself. Vitality in life? Or doom and gloom? And I would see our society as if you're watching the news and all of the casts across this wondrous nation of ours and the world, that the focus has been on negativity. And it has been on negativity for quite some time. But it is up to each of us to create the change that's necessary. And the only way that we can do that is to change our minds. We must start to think differently. And we must start to do it as a collective, as a group of individuals that focus in like-mindedness on the transformation. That is one aspect of our evolution. The greater evolution starts with self, because everything that is happening around us is because of how we see ourselves. So I would ask you, how do you see you? Lighthearted? Joyful? Loving? Compassionate and kind? Hopeful? Faithful? Deserving and worthy? Or is there something less than those qualities that you perceive? And I will tell you, even in those negative qualities, you will find the greater truth of yourself. Because we cannot have one without the other. How are we able to see the wonder that we are if we're not able to see our own iniquities? Those parts of us that fail at times. Those parts that seek something greater, but come somehow short of the expectation that we have placed. And it could be as simple as going to school, if you remember. Remember going to school and getting that grade, and you thought it was going to be so much better. And you didn't achieve the mark that you set for yourself, perhaps. Life is that same way. It is what we as individuals begin to put in the forefront of our thinking. Where do I want to be? How do I want to live? How can I speak this to you? I can tell you because 16 years ago, I was told I was going to die. I had no chance that my opportunity for life was limited. Someone told me that. They were my mirror. They were the mirror of my anguish and my disappointments, my struggles and my battles. They were the individual that would come forth and show me myself so that I could see me more clearly and then ask, is this my truth? Is this the total essence of my being? That at 39 years old, I would leave this world? And my answer was no. My answer was no. We are not defined by other people's words, but we are guided by them often. People that come to us and share their thoughts, even their negativity, somehow show us a new path. They elevate us to a place where we can say, no, there is more to life than what you've stated. And I have a choice. I choose life. I do not choose death. For my mind is the builder, as is yours. We have the capacity of consciousness to shift our realities, to change our understandings, to perceive more than what has been given to us, to learn life lessons. And if we haven't learned them all, our God is more than happy to send an advocate on our behalf, which would be any one of you. One that might stand before another and say, have you seen this from this perspective? Have you looked through my eyes and not yours. We have struggled so much throughout the ages, but in that struggle we have gained great wisdom. We have learned who we have the potential of being, and we have learned that we have the capabilities and talents to choose. To choose the path. And that path that you choose, yes, it can be rocky and it can be rough. It can bring you to your knees sometimes. It can give you a new perspective. Because sometimes when we elevate ourselves so high, we're always looking down on everything else. And at times we must be brought to our knees so that we're looking up. So that we can see differently. From another angle. And our ears enable us to hear the words of another. But what do? We come to a place where we filter those words to suit our nature, our attitude, our feelings, our emotions. And we bring all those words that were shared as wisdom for our understanding into our life experience. And we say, that's true for me. For in the words that we may have heard, there was a semblance, a small fragment of truth that resonated in this little heart of yours. That small spark that said, oh, I hold a place within you. And the words that are now being spoken are powerful and true because you've either lived them or are living them, and you haven't let them go. So in my case, I had an illness come upon me so that I would be able to deal with my emotions. And I needed a physician to come and tell me it was the end of my life. To realize only if I choose. So what will you choose today? Do you choose to live? I love the song by Tim McGraw. It says, live like you are dying. If I told you every night when you closed your eyes that you died, would you believe me? That each night you leave this temple that you call home, this corporal body, and you traverse levels of consciousness beyond your human understanding. You return home. You speak to beings of highly evolved natures. Perhaps even yourself in some future understanding that knows so much more wisdom. And then in the morn, you find yourself being retracted from that realm with your silver cord like a spring. Drawing you back into this corporal existence, this physical body, where everything's feeling weighted down and heavy. But if I told you you died last night, and that yesterday no longer existed, and that the past no longer holds you bound, and today is a new day, would you believe me? Would you believe that every night you die and every morning you're born again? To live. Not wondering about what was, but knowing that what was already happened. You cannot change the past, right? At least that's what they tell us. You already lived it. What you can enjoy about the past is the wisdom you gained, the knowledge, the struggle, the overcoming, and this present moment. Where are you now? Where do you want to be? What does it look like? Imagine you were painting a picture. What would you paint? What would the story be? Would you paint it differently? You are the artist. You are the one that paints your future. It's a matter of choice how that future unfolds. You can paint many, many avenues, many doors, and many people. Different races, colors, and creeds. And all of them being drawn forth by your will and your wishes. And we don't do it by accident. We do it with purposeful intention so that we may evolve and grow and be more. More than we currently perceive ourselves to be. Many of you have already heard the phrase that you are a master. Or you've heard the phrase, when the student is ready, the master appears. Of course the master will appear. You're part of that mastership. And those individuals that are coming before you are simply the reflection of you. Every single one of them. It doesn't matter if they're a stranger. Everyone. And don't limit it to humanity. It could be the dog, the bird, the deer. It could be any one of nature's wonders, a simple flower that you perhaps have passed time and time again and never noticed, and then one day that flower spoke to you and said, notice me, see me. And the message is to see you, see your beauty, your radiance, your aroma, your grace, your compassion. Every day, we are offered a new beginning. We have a choice on how we will proceed. Which road we will take, bumpy or smooth, wide or narrow, it does not matter. I love my guides at one time that given me a great metaphor. They showed me a tree, and they showed me a road. I was walking towards the tree, and then I saw the tree trunk almost lay down to become the road. And I could see the bark of the tree that I was walking on. And there were parts that were really smooth that I could walk in, and others were rough. And then as I continued to walk, I came to the base and started to look up. And I saw the many avenues of this tree, all of its wondrous branches. And every branch made with purpose. And within each branch, more branches and leaves at the end. And Spirit said, do you see? And I said, yes. And he asked, do you truly see? And I said, what is it that I am missing? That each and every branch of what you see will reach the sun. It matters not the short or the long, whether you go to the right or to the left, or if you go straight. Each one, in its infinite wisdom, will reach for the sun. It will reach its final destination. And it matters not which path you've taken. So you've never made a mistake. We've never made a mistake. We're always on the right path. And every avenue we take just gives us a different perspective, a different insight into who it is we are, and where it is we're going, and how we have chosen to get there. And all of it, a success. An evolution. An expansion of our true nature. So if you find yourself beating yourself up about, oh, I shouldn't have done this, and I could have done that, I would like you to think more along these lines. You are in the right and perfect place for you at this moment, and at any given time, you may choose to shift. And that too will be the right and perfect shift for the right and perfect reason at the right and perfect moment. And that's the truth. No one can tell us who it is we are to be. We define ourselves. We can hear other people's perspectives. But it is we who choose to hear the words, and it is we who choose to either apply them or ignore them. My doctor said I would die. I'm either very, very much alive, or you're talking to an amazing spirit who has managed to manifest herself in the physical world. That is my truth. What's yours? Something to think about, isn't it? Remember, every slumber and will be here. Thank you.